Christ come to him by in a dream. One sunny day in Texas, a girl named Chloe was on her way to a car dealer shop to get the new Mustang that she's been saving up for. The Mustang was bright neon yellow color with two black stripes from the front to the back with a fancy design on the side of it. The car also has good gas mileage and black leather seats. She just moved from New York and was tired of riding an old beat-up smart car that smelled like fish guts and rotten food, and was glad that this was her last day to drive it. But little did she know that everything was about to change. Pause it. Chloe is riding her old car on the highway on her way to pick up her new car. She noticed that all the cars on the highway started to shrink until it turned into a bicycle. Each bicycle had a number of seats of people who were riding. Even the buses had 20 or more seats. Chloe was shocked of what just happened and started to worry the car she has been saving up for will be a bicycle too. Chloe was not a biker and did not like to spend her entire life riding a bicycle everywhere. She hoped that everything would be back to normal the next day, so she waited for the next day to pick up her car. When she woke up the next morning, she went to see if everything was back to normal, but things just got worse. Now the airplanes were turning into flying bikes. Chloe was mad and puzzled. She went to go talk to the scientist to see what was going on and if he had a solution to fix the problem. He said he knew how to fix it, but he did not have the right stuff to make it, and asked if Chloe can get the stuff for him. Unfortunately, what she needed to find was all the way in Alaska. She had no transportation but a bicycle. So she thought that maybe they were not having the same issue that they were having in Texas, and she would be able to get a car there. It was becoming night, and she was halfway out of Texas going down a large hill. When her bike lost control, she started heading towards a river. She could not stop the bike, so she fell into the calm river. Now what she thought, I do not have anything to travel with. I guess I just have to walk, until she spotted a log that looked like a raft and decided to use it to travel in. She got in a boat-shaped log and headed down the river. All of a sudden, the winds started to pick up. The river started to stir up. Now it was like white water rafting. The log started to toss and turn until it flipped over. Chloe was able to escape the river, but she was soaked from head to toe. The river helped her go farther, and she was finally getting closer to Alaska, but she was really cold. She found a hotel to dry off and sleep, and got some food to eat. She decided to buy another bike from a small house that sold bikes. She tried to pick up the fastest one, but it would take too much time, so she just chose a random one, headed off to the rest of her journey. The river helped her get closer to Alaska. She was on the border of Canada waiting for her boat to arrive, but she soon figured out boats have been turned into bikes too. The bike problem was heading all over the USA, so she decided to swim until the water got cold and she knew that she was at Alaska. Chloe looked all over for the ingredients to find the poison until she spotted on top of a small hill that she was looking for it. What she was looking for. It was not hard to get it, so after she got it, she started to head back home. to live in the cold state and how she saw an airplane fly overhead. That's funny, she thought, I thought everything was turned into bikes. She rode the plane back home and asked the scientist why everything was back to normal. It turned out he already had the ingredients after all. Chloe was mad that she had to go through all of that for nothing, but she was happy she was able to get her brand new car till everything started to turn into motorcycles. And not send other people to do tasks if you don't know if it's worth it. Citations.